Peptide therapy for long COVID. Hi, this is Jacqueline. I'm back with my next video. So today I'm going to talk about peptides. My new naturopathic doctor did recommend peptide therapy for me. So I'm going to go over the three peptides I am taking, the benefits of that peptide, and then how it is administered. So the first peptide I am taking is called BPC-157. And what that does is it triggers formation of new blood vessels, promotes healing, and induces faster regeneration of cells. The second one is called thymosin alpha 1, and that stimulates stem cells and aids in the production of new immune cells. It also kills bacteria, fungus, and viral infection. The last one is called thymosin beta 4. It promotes systemic healing and improves wound healing and repair throughout the body, including the brain, the spinal cord, and the heart. It travels easily throughout the body, promoting faster healing. How it works is these peptides were shipped to me. They are just little bottles of liquid, and I also got the syringes. So how you do it is you just measure out the peptides into one syringe. You go ahead and inject it subcutaneously into the stomach region. So I am going to do the peptides every day for 1 month, and then overall see if I've noticed any benefit from it. So far, I've been on it about 10 days, feeling pretty good, but I will definitely keep you guys posted. So if you have done peptides, please go ahead and leave a comment below. So I just wanted to pop into this video because I want to give you 4 tips that will make this experience better for you if you've never done peptides. So as I mentioned, the provider will go ahead and they'll send you the syringes, and they'll also send you all of the peptides. So how it works is the little peptides, for me, they told me to go ahead and refrigerate the peptides. So I go ahead and store them in the refrigerator. And then the peptides actually have the name of the peptide on them. But how much you need to inject from each peptide is on the prescription bottle. So I make sure to keep the peptide in the prescription bottle so I make sure I know how much to inject, because they're not the same from each peptide. What you want to make sure you do, of course, is wash your hands, and you want to get an alcohol swab and make sure you clean the area. And the area will be around your belly area, usually a few inches on each side of your belly button. So the first tip is going to be you want to check for air bubbles. So what I mean is when you go ahead and you get your needle and you place it into the peptide bottle, there is a little kind of spongy part at the top of the peptide bottle where you insert the needle. What you want to do is you want to hold it upside down, and then you want to pull back on the needle. But what happens is as that liquid gets lower in that peptide, if you put the needle up too far, you're going to basically be getting air.
Oh.
And then you're going to have a bunch of little air pockets and bubbles in the syringe. So you want to make sure that you don't insert the needle all the way. You kind of pull back on it so that when you pull back on the needle, you're getting the recommended dosage of each peptide. So because I do 3 different peptides, I do use the same syringe. So I go ahead and measure out each peptide. Next, what is helpful for me is to use this lovely magnifying glass. I actually think we bought this for my kids, but it lights up, so it makes it very, very easy to see the angle of the needle going in while you inject it. So what I mean is when I was watching the video of how to do these injections, they said to come at a 90 degree angle, and actually that was extremely painful. So what I did is I got this magnifying glass so I can go ahead and look at the needle so I can see the angle of the needle. There is a part of the needle that's actually cut away. And when you put it up against your skin, you kind of lay that piece that's cut away up against the belly area. So it's almost at a 45 degree angle. So of course you may not need the magnifying glass, but I do, and I actually really like it. And it's very easy to see the angle underneath the magnifying glass. But because my eyesight is not so great, it really helps me see exactly how to angle it, and it makes it a lot more comfortable. And I actually had poor eyesight before COVID, so I can't really blame that on COVID. Even though I do start to notice that any aches and pains I feel, it's always like, Is it COVID? I don't know if you guys feel that same way. I mean, there's things I've had for years, but it's like you feel it and it's very disconcerting. And I wouldn't be quite surprised if my eyesight is slightly worse after COVID, but I can't completely blame it on that. But anyway, the magnifying glass is awesome. Angle the needle, the part that's cut away, go in at a 45, and it'll make it much, much more pleasant for you. Lastly, what you want to do is you do want to switch sides. So you want to do your right side and your left side of your belly, because if you're constantly doing the same side, I notice that you start to get a little bit of bruising and the area can get uncomfortable. after I inject the peptide, I also kind of just like rub the area because the liquid kind of bubbles up. So I tend to try to go in a little bit slower with the injection because I notice when I push it in really quickly, I feel like it almost is like a little kind of bubble of liquid in the area, and then I have to sort of massage it around. I mean, I don't really know what's technically better, but I do feel like if I inject it a little bit slower, it sort of disperses without having like this pocket of liquid right where I injected the peptide. So I hope these few tips help you out if you are doing peptides or really any other kind of subcutaneous injection. If you have any other tips that make the peptide experience a little bit more pleasant, please leave a comment. I know that at the end of the day, when you have to get needles and do injections, it's not really very pleasant, but I did notice that those steps help make it easier, especially best tip is angling that needle, and it'll make it a lot less painful for you. And speaking of peptides, peptides stimulate stem cells. So if you are interested at all in stem cell therapy, you must watch my video about life-saving stem cell therapy for long COVID patients. So please check that out if you have not been able to. I will continue to report and continue to update all of you on everything that I am doing. So until then, please be well, and as always, peace.
I'm glad you made it here.
Cause we're here.
Make sure to like and subscribe.